Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is June 11th, 2017. This is the Holy Trinity. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. We have special music about halfway through the service. Dorothy Ayers will be singing The Holy City.
Good morning, and welcome to worship this morning. I'm Pastor Bonny, Kinnunen, and I serve Trinity Lutheran down on the southeast side of town from 1912. And I know you. And I serve Trinity Lutheran from 1998 to 2006. And it's nice to be back in town. I'm glad to see you all here in worship, and thank you for coming here. It is a little bit warm today, and if you're sitting there fanning, I will certainly feel okay, and maybe you could all come forward and fan this way. That would be good, too, so I can receive some of that luxury. Let us confess our sins with the order of confession found on page 94. We'll use the left hand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one. Most merciful God, we confess
that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may walk in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and it is for his sake that God forgives all of our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare unto you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us sing our opening hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy.
Was written by Reginald Heber, who lived 1783-1826. We're happy to have you with us, worshiping Holy Trinity today.
and also with you.
Clark will be reading, doing the readings.
The first lesson for today is from the first chapter of Genesis. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome, separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth to bear fruit with the seed in it. And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky, separate the day from the night. Let them be for signs for the seasons and for the days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth. And it was so. God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and separate the light from the darkness. God saw that it was good, and there was evening, and there was morning, and the fourth day. God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. God created the great sea monsters, and every living creature that moves of every kind, with which the waters swarm. And every winged bird, every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and morning, and the fifth day. God said, let them earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle, creeping things, wild animals, and the earth of every kind. And it was so. God made wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the birds of the air, over the cattle, over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image, and in the image of God created them. Male and female created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with its seed and its fruit, and you shall have them for food, and to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has breath of life, I have given you every creeping plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, and the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all of their multitude. And on the seventh day God finished the work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day for all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm for today is the eighth psalm. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of the heavens and children.
You have set up fortress against your enemies, despise the foe and avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, you have set in their courses.
What are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them? Human beings that you should care for them?
Yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor, you crown them.
You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have made all things under your dignity.
All flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts in the field,
the birds of the air,
the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. The second reading for today is from the 2 Corinthians 13th chapter. Paul writes, finally, brothers and sisters, farewell. Put things in order, listen to my appeal. Agree with one another. Live in peace. God.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel acclamation as our guest pastor, Pastor Bonny, Kinnunen, has ascended the pulpit by reading the gospel of today, which is on the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This is June 11, 2017, Holy Trinity Sunday.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
We will sing the hymn, and then I want to tell you that Dorothy Ayers will be doing special music for her. She will be singing the Holy City. She's the granddaughter of Sally Adam, and she's a senior at the state.
Music today by Dorothy Ayers, granddaughter of Dr. Sally Abbott. She will be singing The Holy City.
I'm
Dorothy Ayers, granddaughter of Dr. Sally Abbott.
As you were singing, I was recalling my own trip to Jerusalem, and there was a busload of people, truly a busload of people, and Jerusalem is on a hill. And so you go up to Jerusalem almost from any angle that you get to Jerusalem. And I've always wondered what the verses were, because when the crowd was singing Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the in-betweens are da-di, 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 da. So I thank you for filling in the gap there. It's really, really wonderful. What a gift you have. I brought with me today my first one. And somebody asked earlier if it indeed was my tricycle, and it is. It was the one that I stood in front of at the picture that was taken when I was about 3 years old. And you're wondering, so what are you bringing a 50-plus-year-old tricycle to worship with you, right? Well, let me tell you this. Today is Holy Trinity Sunday. And what does a tricycle have?
Three wheels.
Now, curious thing about a tricycle, if one wheel doesn't work, you don't have a bicycle. What do you have? A tricycle that doesn't work. And same thing if you have two wheels that don't work. What do you have? A tricycle that doesn't work. Because a tricycle is meant to be used as a tricycle. Even if two wheels are gone, you still don't have a unicycle that's left. Because you need the three wheels on a tricycle to make it work adequately. In considering the Holy Trinity, we have three beings. We have God helping help fill me out here. We've got the Father,
the Son,
the second,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Trinity today was in our scripture lessons when God was telling his disciples, or when Jesus telling his disciples what their task was. He said, go. Go out into the world and baptize the nations in the name of the what? Father,
Son,
and the Holy Spirit. And as we know from seminary, as I know from seminary, it was God the Father who sent Jesus, and Jesus promised the Holy Spirit when he left. And so when we consider the Trinity, we think about all three entities traveling as a unit, much like a tricycle. So where God the Father is, there is the Son. Where the Son is, there is the Holy Spirit. And where the Holy Spirit is, the Father and the Son are with them all together all the time. You can get into very serious theological conversations when you say, well, okay, when Jesus was on the cross, was God being crucified too? Was the Holy Spirit part of that mix? You can get into some very challenging arguments. Was God separate from Jesus at that point in time or not? I tell you what, brains that are far more adept at these theological conversations than I can talk for hours. I will spare you that conversation. But to know that the Holy Trinity is with us always in any and many ways in our lives. The task of the Holy Trinity is to continue to encourage us in life. We have God the Creator who made everything on earth and all that is. There have been times when I ask the confirmation students, did God make the pews? And they're thinking, no, Johnny down in the pew factory made the pews. And I said, but what is a pew made of? I said, well, a tree. I said, who made the trees? And they would say, well, God. Yeah, so God made the pews. And we can take that back on anything and everything that is created in the world, that God has created you and me and all that exists. God sent Jesus into the world for one particular purpose. One is for us to get to know God, Jesus, personally. And the second was to redeem us from our sin. You know that there is no other world religion that God came to the people know, the young fellow here, I think your name is Nick. Who's Nick? He's going to play the cello. You know, you look, I don't know, how old might Nick be? 10? 12? 7? 5? However old Nick is, Jesus was that age in this world. And so when you think about Jesus and you wonder, well, Jesus is out there somewhere, you can say, wait a minute, you know, Jesus lived among us and I'm 7 years old, 8 years old. Jesus knew what it was to be a 7 or 8 year old. So Jesus came to live among us, with us, and through us, and he died on the cross to redeem us from our sins. When he was preparing to leave his disciples, he promised them one thing that was very important. He said, I will send to you the Comforter, the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, who will continue to live within and through you throughout all of our days. So that means for those of us who are beyond 33, and I'm not asking how far beyond you are, but to know that however old we are, that the Trinity, God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit continue to be with us in each of our days. And so even at the time when I'm with a parishioner who is in the process of passing, I know that for certain that God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit is there welcoming that person, hanging out with that person as they are breathing their last, and welcoming them into the gates of heaven with all the joy and grandeur that might be. So the scripture tells us to go out into the world, and that he will be with us, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. But did you notice that first piece in the scripture text? And how many of you have ever doubted your faith? Anybody willing to admit that? How many have ever wondered if this business is all actually true? You are in good company. For in our scripture text this morning, it says, now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to a mountain which Jesus had directed them. And when they saw him, they worshiped him. What does that next phrase say?
Some doubted.
But some doubted. So of those 11, they had been with Jesus, they saw him crucified, they seen him resurrected, they are now with him on the mountainside, hearing all that he has to tell them. And the scriptures tells us, though some doubted. But what is the cool thing about doubting anything? If you doubt something, you have two choices. Well, there's probably a few more than two, but let's work with the number two. You have the choice to continue to allow your doubt to be. And you can just go on doubting. Some people are quite happy in doubting whatever they're doubting about. Or you can choose to find out the truth. You can choose to seek out others who have believed in faith and to hear their stories. You can choose to talk with others who have chosen to not believe in Christ and what they believe and how they are. You can do a research study on how does this all work. And anyone that I've known who has asked those particular questions, how does faith work, and have sought out clear and concise answers from individuals who believe and from individuals who do not believe and from the scriptures themselves, they typically come back to the answer, God is real, faith is real, and that I need to be a part of that experience in faith. And to remember that God is always with us, even in our doubts. God is with us and leading us and guiding us, even though we question our faith, and even though we wonder, what is God up to now? Because there are times in our lives when we don't know what God is up to. And all we can do is hang on through the ride that is to come and to continue to walk in faith all of our days. lived out their faith faithfully to come to Springfield, Ohio to tell us about faith. So it is our job to be the link from this generation to the one that is to come, to continue to display God's love and to show God's care to those that He presents before us and to even those that we might find elsewhere in our lives. Go out and tell the world. Go out and baptize the nations in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, for this day when a simple tricycle can help us to understand the Holy Trinity. We thank you for this day for us to be reminded that the disciples even doubted and questioned this experience of faith. And yet they continued to believe in who you are and what you do. Encourage us in our lives as we continue on in faith, that we will indeed profess your word of saving grace to those that are before us, to those that you have given to us in our lives, and to those that have yet to hear. Give us courage to speak the words that need to be said, and an open heart to hear and be in conversation. It is in your name that we pray. Amen. Let us profess our faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. And as we say the creed, you will notice that this also represents the Trinity, for the first paragraph talks about God, the second paragraph talks about Jesus, and the third paragraph talks about the Holy Spirit. So let us begin. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. For the offering of the offertory this morning, Nick Ayers will be playing the cello. Let us pray.
Carol Glaze and Connie Singleton are the ushers, and Nicholas Ayers, our grandson, is going to be playing Ode to Joy on the cello. Very proud of Nicholas and his accomplishment. He's autistic, but he's done very well and worked hard, and he's very good on this song, Ode to Joy, on the cello. Thank you.
That was Nicholas Ayers.
What a great delight to have such talented musicians for music this morning. Gathered and enlightened and empowered to serve, let us pray for the church, the nations, and all people seeking God's mercy and care. Our response is hear our prayer. Please stand if you are accustomed to do so. We praise you, O God. Help us to proclaim your majestic name, that disciples of all nations may come to know and glorify you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We marvel at how you have given human beings mastery over the works of your hands. Make us faithful and caring for all that you have declared good. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for the gospel of Jesus Christ, our Savior, and pray that we will be bold in sharing the hope and joy of our baptismal inheritance with others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We eagerly await the continued outpouring of the Spirit's gifts, that we may minister to the poor, the troubled, the unemployed, the lonely, and all who are in need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Father, we pray for the sick and the injured. Give them strength and relief from pain. Provide them with the care that is needed. Provide compassionate helpers and good medicine. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord, help us to remain steadfast in our faith, following in the path of all the blessed saints who have been baptized in the name of the Holy Trinity, and now dwell in your everlasting glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive our prayers, Holy God, and give us all we need for this day and the days that are to come. Through the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Together let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you his peace.
Amen.
Let us sing the hymn, Holy God, we praise you.
This is another hymn for Holy Trinity Sunday. Again, we don't know who wrote it. The author is unknown, but it was written in the 1800s. It was translated by Clarence Walworth, and the melody is a Viennese melody in 1774. Holy Trinity Sunday.
Oh, man.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you for watching our service on YouTube. This is June 11th, 2017, Holy Trinity Sunday. We worship the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. We're thankful to Pastor Bonny, our guest pastor, and her wonderful lesson about the tricycle representing the Holy Trinity. It's a good way for us to understand the Holy Trinity, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Although it is difficult to understand, we know that we have the help of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. St. John's Lutheran Church, the corner of Wittenberg and Columbia, we invite you to come to our service at 10:30. We have our service in the sanctuary. During the summer, from Memorial Day to Labor Day, we are at the Melody Cruise Inn Drive-In. Worship God in your car. Come as you are. We're spinning outdoors, rain or shine. We had our service this morning, and we thank God for our wonderful, beautiful weather, for the service this morning at the drive-in, and also for the 10:30 service. I'm proud of my granddaughter, Dorothy Ayers, who sang Holy City, and Nicholas Ayers, who played the cello, Ode to Joy. There's extra added to service today. I'm your announcer, Sally Abbott, and Linda Fox is your videographer. We're happy to have you with us. We invite you to share this service with others. Be the witness, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Be the witness to those all over the world. And you can start here by showing our service to others. Show them how to get it on the YouTube and watch it yourself. Come to our service. We have Holy Communion celebrating the first and third Sunday of each month, festivals, and every Wednesday evening. We have a new festival this year added by the Catholic Church in honor of St. Mary Magdalene, the Apostle to the Apostles. She has her own festival. It's the first time. We're happy to have you worshiping with us today, and we invite you to notice the flowers, the beautiful flowers Pastor Pollock and Gina have given to the honor of God and also to their son Matthew's birthday. We thank you for watching us. We thank you for your attentiveness on YouTube. We hope that you received a blessing. We pray for you, and we want God to bless you through everything you do, to be with you, to Jesus to be in with your heart, and that Jesus to be the master of all your life, to walk with you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, throughout eternity, through life, now, and through eternity. As we receive next week the body and blood of Jesus Christ, who died on the cross to save us from sin, and give us eternal life, all those who eat his body and drink his blood. He says in John, we will receive eternal life. And we also take this for communion for everybody in the world, to bring peace in the world. That's our prayer. Peace and love and unity. Thanks be to God. And watch us every time you turn on YouTube. Watch us several times. That's okay. You don't have to just watch us once. Praise God that you are with us. We pray for you and pray for our ministry. We're good.